Good morning to all. Good morning, my dear children. Welcome to Prerana family. Myself, Arina, lecturer in chemistry. So today we are going to discuss about a bridge course. So from every one class to when you are moving from one class to another class, you have heard about a bridge course. What exactly this bridge course is? Bridge is nothing but something which connects one point to another point, and it makes the movement easy, to move easily. So we are going to construct a bridge which connects from one point to another point. That means that our journey will be easier from one point to another point, or from point A to point B. To make the journey easier, we are going to construct a bridge. So here also, like that only. So it is an additional course that helps you to understand the subjects of PU or pre-university in prior. It will prepare you for your pre-university journey. So why this is needed? Why this bridge course is needed? So we have observed that students till 10th standard are used to a particular study pattern or a particular format or method, so which might not be the adequate or the proper method for the next level, that is for the PU level. So to make you ready for the PU level, we have to go with the bridge course. So this bridge course will help you to understand the need and scope in change in learning pattern from 10th standard to meet the expectations of the PU level. So this will make you understand what you need to study or how you need to study, what all will be there in the PU level. So it is just like a foundation or a base which you need to know to understand the concepts in the PU level or pre-university level. Clear? So that's why it is very, very important. So next one, that is science. Right from your primary level, you have been studying this as a subject, science. And as soon as if I ask you to define science, so immediately the statement is, it is a systematic way of gaining knowledge. So we have studied this definition. But have you tried to understand what is that systematic way? Systematic, the word itself says that. So it is, let us take an example. So every day of your routine will take an example, not the day in a lockdown. So before that, let us recall your school days. When you are going to school, let us recall them. So when you are going to school in the morning, you used to get up and complete your routine works, that is brushing up, taking bath and all. After that, by 9 o'clock, you'll be taking your breakfast. By 9:30, you'll be entering your school. School, there will be assembly. So immediate after assembly, you'll be entering into your classrooms. So morning, some 4 classes will be there, which is prescribed in the timetable. So according to the scheduled timetable, classes will run. 1 o'clock, you'll be having your lunch break. After that, afternoon session, some 3 periods will be there. Same as usual, which has been scheduled. So in a day, you may get one physical education class also and some other activity class also. After that, by 4:30, you'll be reaching home. After that, snacks will be ready. You'll be taking snacks. After that, you'll be going for either playing or to your friends. By 7:30, you'll be back home, completing your homework and completing your studies. 9:30, dinner, 10:30, sleep. So this was your routine day. The same way, the next working day also, same thing. Morning, you'll get up, 9:30, you'll reach school, assembly, classes, again the same way. So that is what the systematic way. So every day at the same time, you'll be doing the same work. So step by step, each step, one after the other. So by 9:30, you won't take your lunch. isn't it or not? 9:30 breakfast. Same, next day also 9:30 breakfast only. That is what the systematic way. So here also, so we are gaining the knowledge, we are understanding the concept in a systematic way. And that is what called science. So now as you have entered now into PU level, so the concept or understanding the concept or studying science is little bit different. So what is the different and how the modification we have done in the statement we shall see. So science is the study of the physical and natural world through observations and experiments. So science, that is nothing but in the nature around us, many numerous number of processes or reactions are taking place. And this numerous number of reactions, processes, we are understanding them through our observation. Through our observation and expectations. We are understanding them through our observations and experiments. So, if at all, if you are understanding any process or anything with observation and experiment, then that method of study is called as science. Clear? So, anything you are observing and by the experiment you are confirming that one. So, whatever the observation we have made, that observation if you are confirming by conducting an experiment, then that way of understanding the concept is called as science. So next, so science, to develop a science, so there are what a definite number of steps are there. So that step is nothing but scientific method. So science develops through a definite steps and the definite step is called as scientific method. So we said that science is developing. How the science is developing? In the olden days, if you talk to your parents, you'll come to know. In the earlier days, for light's sake, we used to use kerosene lamps. So after that kerosene lamps, after a few years, so we got an electricity with that normal yellow color bulb was there. So after that, it was tube lights. So after that, nowadays it is LED. Along with that, we have neon bulbs also for decoration purpose or on the shops advertisement. You can observe that neon lights. So as time had passed away, so science has developed right from the kerosene lamp to our LED lights. Likewise for fire also. So earlier we used to use stones. So the friction of stone from which the fire was fire used to get. After that we started using matchboxes. After that we were having lighters. So LPG gases we started using. So after that, as the time is going, much easier. Our life had become much easier. As the science is developing, so the life is also becoming much and much easier, as well as much and much more comfortable also. So science in a systematic way, we are studying. And that systematic method or systematic way, we call it as scientific method. So the scientific method involves four steps. So scientific method of study involves four steps. Which are those four steps? So the first step is making observation. So making observation is nothing but, let us take an example. So Newton's laws. Newton's laws was not made only by apple falling from a tree. So Newton had he didn't frame his laws. So that was the first observation. Falling down an apple was the first observation. Then what he did, he took some other substances. Two or three balls he had taken with different masses. And he made all those to fall from a great height. He observed. likewise he had taken similar same mass substance, same mass two substance he had taken and made that one to fall from different heights, and he had observed all those things. With all those observations, so he had formulated a law. Nothing but statements. He had drawn a statement. So he had jotted down all those statements, and then he had developed a theory. Clear it is? First observation was made, and from the observation, from each observation, a statement was drawn, and that is called as a law, formation of law. And after formation of law, he prepared a theory out of it, and that theory was to check whether the theory is correct or not, to confirm that theory, whether the theory is correct or not. Whatever the thing he had jotted down or whatever the thing he had written on the paper was correct or not, to check that one, he had conducted an experiment. Clear? In everything, not only in Newton's laws case, in everything it is like that only. So whatever the observations we make, so based upon that, we are going to take a statements out of it, and that statements will be developed in the form of a theory. That theory, to confirm whether that theory is correct or not, we are going to conduct experiments. If the experiment says it is the theory, it is whatever the theory says and the experiment is going along, both are matching, then no problem. If both are not matching, so experiment is something else and theory, what it says is not matching with the experiment, then we are going to modify the theory according to experiments. Clear? You can't change the experiment. Experiment is a reality. Experiment is a practical thing which happens. Theory we have done on with the help of pen and paper. On pen and paper, we can write our own imaginations. But it may not be true in case of experiments. So when you do practically the experiments, so at that time, you'll come to know whatever you have written on the using pen and paper is correct or not. If it is correct, then no problem. Clear? If it is correct, then no problem. If the theory and the theory as well as experiment is not going along, then we do some modifications. We do some modifications to the theory. Clear it is? So that how we'll be studying a science using a scientific method. And we have one more thing to discuss, that is qualitative observation and quantitative observation. So qualitative observation, let us take an example. So your sister will be telling a statement to you, or your mother will be telling a statement to you. Get some tomatoes. That was a statement said by your mother. Get some tomatoes. So one more person in your family will be telling the same statement. Get 1 kg of tomatoes. So qualitative is the one which gives only information. It gives information to us. So get some tomatoes was the information, or bringing tomatoes from the shop was an information. But along with the information, if some measurements are also there, and that is what called as quantitative observation. Clear it is? So in the statement, get one kg of tomato was an quantitative statement. Get some tomato was an qualitative. Get some tomato was an qualitative which gives only information. Quantitative, when you say along with information, it also shows the measurement. It also gives the measurement. 1 kg. 1 kg was a measurement. Clear it is? So that is what the difference. So qualitative gives only the information. Quantitative gives information, along with that some measurements are also there. clear it is. So that is what the difference between the qualitative and quantitative. Next, the branches of science. So the science has been classified under many branches, but only the required branch only I have chosen to make you understand here. So that is the natural science is being classified into physical science, earth and space science, as well as life science. We require only the two things here. So what when you have chosen the science combination, so you will be studying physics, chemistry, which comes under physical science, and maths, which is the common to all. So that is physics, chemistry and maths is the compulsory subjects you will be studying. So life science is the optional one. So life science is nothing but biology. Clear? So under science combination, physics, chemistry, maths is the compulsory one, which comes under physical science. And the optional one is either you can choose life science, that is biology, or you can choose computer science, or you can choose statistics. Clear? That is about the science combinations I said. But now, according to the branches of science, we have physical science. Physical science has been classified as physics and chemistry, and earth science and space science are classified. Earth science has been classified as geology, meteorology, and space science has been classified as astronomy. Oceanography comes under earth science. Life science, botany, zoology, that is life science is nothing but biology. So biology can all can be classified under botany and zoology. So again, there are further classifications, that is genetics, ecology and all. But we are going to, in our PU level, we are going to discuss the physics, chemistry, mathematics, botany, zoology, which comes under biology. So either you can choose that one, computer science or statistics. Clear? Now, so we'll move on to our actual topic, that is chemistry. So welcome to the world of chemistry. So as soon as I say chemistry, the first thing will come to your mind is a lab with many people with apron and many glassware, many glass bottles in the lab, and colorful solutions. Some vapors will be coming, or some will be observing some test tubes, or some glassware they'll be observing. So all these things will be coming to your mind. So chemistry is not only regarding lab or colorful solutions or glass bottles or in the lab. It is much more than that. Our entire day-to-day life, whatever we enjoy, so everything involves chemistry. So what is this chemistry? So first we shall study the definition, the normal the definition which has been given in our textbooks we shall study. So after that definition, then we'll move on to our most exciting word of chemistry, that where all chemistry is involved. So we'll see that one also. So it is a branch of science which deals with the study of composition, structure and properties of matter, and the changes which it undergoes in composition as well as energy during various processes. So when you observe the statement here, so it is a branch of science which deals with the study of composition. Composition means, suppose we are studying about matter. So it is about matter. Matter is the thing in universe. So what all substances, what all things are there, all of them are being called as matter. In the universe, what all things or what all substances we have, all of them have been called as matter. What is that matter definition? Matter is something which occupies space and possesses the mass. That means that what all things in nature it is there, all can be called as matter because all the substances has mass also and they occupy space also. Clear it is now. So what composition? Composition means, so the matter is made up of. So suppose if at all if you consider a milk, milk is an matter. Or suppose let us consider we have taken an tea, we have prepared a tea out of it. So tea is a matter. So tea occupies some space and it has some mass or in the form of volume also we can measure them. So that tea is made up of water, it is made up of milk, tea powder and sugar. That is what the composition of tea is. Clear it is. So the substance or the thing which is made up of what? So all those things are called as composition of that particular substance. So now the composition of tea is water, milk, sugar as well as tea powder. So with all these things the tea is made up of and that is what called composition. So it's a structure. Tea is a liquid. So it is a liquid and properties. So usually whenever you prepare a tea will be hot in nature. Isn't it or not? We are going to boil all those things. So it is hot in nature. All these are the properties of that tea. So that is what we are going to study. It is not about tea we are studying. It is about all the things which is existing in universe or in nature we are studying. And the changes. So when you say properties, I said only a one property of tea. So when you take any other things, any other matter if you are considering, how it is going to react with another substance? How much it is useful to the useful to mankind? So all these things, how much it is useful as well as harmful to the mankind, all these things we are going to study. And along with that and the changes which it undergoes in composition as well as energy during various processes. That is nothing but, so what when it is undergoing any reaction, it is processes when we are telling, it is in general we are telling, so that is nothing but reactions. When we are checking any reactions with that particular substance, so how the changes, how the composition changes taking place as well as how the energy changes, because each and every substance consists of some amount of energy in it. So what all energy changes taking place in the particular reaction, that is we are going to study under chemistry. So chemistry is a branch of science which deals with the study of composition, structure and properties and the changes it is undergoing during its reaction in composition as well as the energy. So we shall see one such reaction here. So we have a carbon reacting with the oxygen and it is forming carbon dioxide. Along with the carbon dioxide it is giving out some amount of heat. Clear? So a carbon is there, so which is solid in nature. When you write subscript as yes, it indicates that it is a solid. Clear? So the substance is solid in nature and it is made up of only carbon particles. Clear it is. And when you write G here, so that is nothing but it is a gas. The substance is a gas. So a solid is been reacting with oxygen gas and it is forming an gas here. That is nothing but the composition has changed. Composition, nothing but, so one was carbon, another was oxygen. Now it had formed carbon dioxide. Clear? Carbon is combined with oxygen. That is composition is changed now. As well as you can observe the physical state also slightly it has changed because carbon was an solid. Now the product is gas only. And you can observe some amount of heat is liberated also. So in the reaction when heat is liberated, we call such kind of reactions as exothermic reactions. You'll be coming across with this one in further chapters also. So whenever there is a liberation of heat along with the products, if heat is liberated, we call such reactions as exothermic reactions. Clear it is? And now So that is nothing but energy changes also we have studied. So from the, after the reaction, energy is liberated. So energy changes also we have studied, as well as composition changes also we have studied. And that is what chemistry is. Exothermic reaction where heat is liberated. Heat is liberated and the composition also has changed. So the studying of these things, nothing but chemistry. And not only these things, exactly not only the reactions, we are studying all the processes which is taking place in the nature. In and around us, whatever is taking, because the human body is also matter only. So that means that in human body also many reactions, for every second, many numerous number of reactions are taking place. So that study of that one also is nothing but chemistry itself. So either in the form of heat change or in the form of matter change. So that matter, when it changes, that is nothing but composition is changing. So it has been combining and it has been forming a carbon dioxide. So and heat is liberated. So we call such kind of reactions as exothermic reactions. Clear it is. Next we'll move on to our exciting and most important part of chemistry and most colorful thing. That is chemistry in everyday, in our daily life. So where all we are going to, I mean, it is very important that, so you might be thinking why we need to study chemistry. So why we need to study chemistry is chemistry has made our life very, very beautiful, very comfortable and very exciting also. So that's why there is a need for you to understand what is chemistry and why we should study chemistry and what is the use of chemistry in our daily life. So if we say, if we take any law or if we take any theory, so it may help us or it may not help us in our daily life. But chemistry is not like that. So right from our morning waking up to night you'll be sleeping, until then chemistry is very much required and we are completely dependent on chemistry. For each and every moment, for each and everything, we require chemistry. For what all we require, we shall see. Morning, as soon as you get up, everybody has a habit of brushing your teeth. So that is very, very important. So brush is made up of plastic, which is a product of chemistry. Paste is a chemical. It is a chemical. So the whatever this bristles or fibers are there, it is the product of chemistry. Table salt, nothing but NaCl, sodium chloride, which is a chemical. As I said, we'll be preparing tea in the morning usually. LPG gas burning, so that is a hydrocarbon. Hydrocarbon, LPG, liquid petroleum gas. So that has been burnt in the presence of oxygen, which gives out heat. So because of which cooking purpose is served. So when you add sugar to water, when you add sugar to water or hot water, it is going to dissolve in it. The word dissolve is from chemistry. The sugar is getting dissolved in it. The tea powder is giving out color to it. So that is dissolving, is nothing but boiling, dissolving. All these are from chemistry itself. So you can observe the clothes here, colored. So all these color, nothing but dyes. So which are of chemistry. So the dyes have been prepared and those chemicals will make our daily life very colorful. So likewise, food, what you eat. So all these tasting powders we have, all those preservatives we have, and the color, which gives color as well as which gives aroma to the food, all these are due to the chemistry itself. And one more thing, that is usually you'll be taking, you're familiar with either pizzas or burgers, or along with that some bakery items, that is baked items. So where we'll be using baking powder, that baking powder is nothing but NaHCO3, and table salt, as we have seen already, it is NaCl. So we have vinegar which is been used for preserving which has some sour taste in it, to make all those sauces. To make all those sauces we are going to use, that is what called acetic acid, CH3COOH. So will be dependent on many things for food. As you see here, some fresh foods we have. So in fresh foods also, each and every food is with some chemical present in it. Folic acid we have. So we have carrot, carotene is present. So likewise, we have all vitamins present, all fibers present. So protein is present. So folic acid is present in this. So we have some citrus fruits also over here. So clear. So all these things. So many, all, every moment, whatever we eat, whatever we do, consists of chemistry. So cosmetics, which we cannot leave at all. It is a very important category. So, which makes us look very beautiful. So, cosmetics, I think from the morning to evening, you'll be using most of the products of chemistry. Without that, so soaps, detergents, as well as chalk. Chalk is nothing but CaCO3. So all these things, the table sugar is a C12H22O11. So all these are nothing but chemistry. So chemistry has covered up our life, or it has become an a very important category in our life. Without that, our life will be very miserable and very horrible. So chemistry had made life more colorful as well as more beautiful as well as more comfortable also. So this is our daily life, chemistry in daily life, how much we are dependent on chemistry. So much more than this, we have some very important which we can't be avoided. So chemistry, where we can't be avoiding this chemistry. Without that chemistry, we can't just imagine our life. So such kind of different branches of chemistries are there. So in our next class, we are going to discuss about the different branches of chemistry, and with all these branches, what is needed, why these branches are important, so how many branches we have, and in PU level, exactly in pre-university level, how many branches you are going to study, and which are those branches, why, what all we are going to study under that, will be made known to you. So stay tuned, stay home, stay safe.